Hello everyone, my name is Harold Campos. I'm a principal PM for Azure Integration Services, and today I will present another episode on our mission critical series We Speak, where we emphasize on particular and commonly used technologies in enterprise mission critical environments with Azure Logic Apps. The topic for today's session is IBM IMS. So what is IMS, or the IBM Information Management System? IBM IMS was born in 1966 and is a system used by 95% of Fortune 1000 and was built for the Apollo mission. It performs online transaction processing for applications that access IMS data, as well as data stored for DB2 or COS. And IMS Transaction Manager processes three types of messages: transactions, message switches, and commands. If you've used ATMs before, you will likely use IMS Transaction Manager. Think about all the financial companies worldwide and all the ATMs associated with them, and you get an idea of the breadth of IMS Transaction Manager and the volume of transactions it processes daily, 260 billion per day. You know, this is just to have an idea on how pervasive is IMS in the Fortune 1000. So how does it work? We've been connecting with IMS systems for at least 20 years, at least. So what you are seeing here is I'm going to try to summarize the process of connecting to an IBM IMS system from our cloud, from the Azure cloud. In a Logic Apps workflow, our runtime sends an initial request message to the IMS Connect system on the host. Via IBM supplied host web servers exit routines using the IP address of the mainframe and the port address of the IMS Connect as stored in the TCP/IP profile dataset supplied by IBM for the mainframe. Then the IMS Connect exit routine takes control of the IMS application, and the runtime sends an IMS IP automatic connection or ITOC request header to the ITOC and the exit routine. The ITOC reads at the ITOC header information, locates the correct IMS region, and schedules the execution of an IMS transaction in that IMS region. The exit routine schedules the correct IMS message queue, the IMS control region sends a message, and all of this happens in just milliseconds. So then once the transaction has completed, we'll get the response back in the workflow. But basically, all of these steps that I just described, they occur typically in milliseconds or, in worst case scenario, a few seconds, depending on the conditions of your network. So IBM, the access to legacy systems, it was optimized for a slow network, right? To work with a low amount of resources. So that's why this is very typical in interacting with legacy systems of this kind. Now, how does it work? How do we create a definition to interact with an IMS program in a mainframe? Our IMS Azure integration technologies are based on the IMS Connect programming model that provides access to the IMS systems using TCP/IP. So this model uses the IMS message queue for processing data. If you do need APPC support or LU 6.2, so then we have the IMS transactions using LU 6.2. Available only in host integration server, in the server version of our product. The Visual Studio integration feature of host integration server is required to create a host integration designer XML file that provides the necessary metadata for the IMS program. The first thing that you will be needing is Visual Studio with an installation of host integration server to create a new project where you will have to define the structure that will mimic, as I said, the HIDX file, that will mimic or that will mirror the transaction program in the host. This is going to look like this. So you're going to have a screen where you will be able to create an interface and import a host definition. And then once you have imported the host definition, that is typically a copybook like the one that I just presented, so then you will end up having a structure like this, right? You will have an interface, a method with parameters. Some of these parameters are input, and some of them, well, there is an output parameter here, right? And then once you have completed this process, so then you will be able to store this HIDX file, which is a file that you will have to use from your Logic App in the cloud. A couple of things to mention. First one is that when you are importing a COBOL copybook definition, you should identify the LL, ZZ, and trunk codes and return values of it. The mainframe person will know what I'm talking about because this is information that is required to interact with IMS Connect. And as I said, once the import has finalized, you should save this file, and then you will have to upload it into the maps section in the Logic Apps in the Logic App that you are trying to use to interact with the IMS system. How do I set it up? Once you create an Azure Logic App workflow, you can add the IMS in-app connector, or formerly known as built-in. It will load automatically the HIDX files that are available. So if you have uploaded 10 definitions, so then you will have a dropdown with the 10 definitions, and you will be able to pick one. And then once you pick one, then it will show you which methods were available for you to use. And it will give you the chance to add parameters, input and output parameters. Now, to set up the IBM IMS connector for the first time, so to speak, right, you will require some inputs, and you'll have to create a connection definition. Clearly, this information will have to be provided by your mainframe specialist. You will require at least the IMS system ID, the port number, the ITOC exit name, and the server name. For most types of IMS Connect clients, IMS Connect requires the use of a user message exit routine to manage the messages that are received from and sent to the client. And this is how it's going to look like. You're going to go to the Logic App, you're going to create a workflow, and then once in the workflow, you're going to add an action. You're going to look for IMS, and then you will find the IBM IMS connector. And then you will find the call an IMS program action. So let's see how this works. Here I have my Visual Studio installation. And in this Visual Studio, I was able to import a host definition. And this host definition that was in the form of a copybook, as I said, so it will create this object that I see here, right? That's called IMS Get Balance, which is a fairly straightforward program. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go to the portal. Let me go to the portal now. And I will show you how this looks like from the portal. I have my Logic App that is called IMS Connect. If I go to workflows, a couple of things before I forget. One is that you have to make sure that in your Logic App, the networking configuration is in place to connect to your mainframe first, right? So you will need to enable VNet integration. And for the VNet integration, you will have to interact with peer network with Express Route peer network if you're using Express Route or any other mechanism for hybrid communications. So then you will be assigned a VNet which you will have to integrate with your Logic App for security purposes. Right? It's up to you whether you're going to be enabling inbound traffic or you will apply restrictions on it. But now let me go to the workflow. I'm sorry, the second thing that before I forget is I'll go to the artifacts, and then you will see that in the maps, I have the HIDX file uploaded, right? This is called banking imsconnect.hidx, which is the HIDX that was generated by this interface, by using this interface here, right? Banking imsconnect.hidx. So I uploaded it into the maps section in the Logic App. Then I'll go to the workflow, and in the workflow I will take my test workflow called IMS test. I'll go to the designer, and from there I'll go and I'll show you. It has three steps, right? Three actions. When an HTTP request is received, then call IMS program, and then post a message in a chat or channel. What I'm going to do is I'm going to call this this workflow. So it's fairly straightforward, right? So if I go to call IMS program, so then you will see that I have the HIDX name definition here, right? So then I have the method that is called getBalance, and then I'm entering the input parameter account number, 123456, right? And then the outcome of this of this IMS program will be what is returned by the token picker. Okay, so let me go to the to execute this workflow, and then what's going to happen is that let me show you here. I will go to run history, and then you will see that it's running. Then I'll hit refresh, and then it has completed. So if I go in the history to see what happened, you will see that the HTTP request was triggered, a test call, and then the call to the IMS system was successful and it returned this value 777.12. And I posted the message on Teams. So if I go and open my Teams, then you will see that I have in where is it? Somewhere here. Demo. Let me look for it. Should find it soon. Where is it? Here, host files, then IMS. Here, you will see that this message just arrived. The output is 777.12. Oh, this is the one. Here, sorry, the one at the top. Let me run it again just to make sure that this is not a null message. And run, and then I'll go to Teams again, right? And you will see that this is the last one that ran just now, and it got the response. So as you can see, this is a fairly straightforward workflow, right? So with the connector, we are with the IMS connector, we are simplifying the whole complex process of interacting with IMS systems. As you can see, you can have a fairly complex workflow here, right? And then, but you don't have to deal with the complexity of interacting with an IMS program because we deal with that complexity. And that was it. I hope you enjoy it, right? And thank you for your time. If you need to connect with me, my Twitter handle is hcamposu. You can look for me on LinkedIn, or you can email me at hcampos@microsoft.com. Thank you, everyone.